The disappearance of vision is not good. When there are no dreams, when people have stopped dreaming, it's difficult. And I want us to just put your hands on your head and say, God, baptize me with new visions and dreams. Just give me new dreams, oh God. Let me not just wake up and go to bed. May visions come in the name of Jesus. Father, bless us with dreams, oh God. That is your word. You said you will give us dreams. And the young men shall see visions. The old men shall dream dreams. In the day of the Lord. Baptize your church with dreams, oh God. Let there be vision, oh God. That we can look and point, this is the way to Canaan, the promised land. This is where the Lord is leading your church to. Not to doom, but to a place of glory. When I wake up in the night, when I stand in the morning, I'm thinking, I don't want to miss this place, Lord. The place you have prepared. So, Lord, I don't fight like somebody that doesn't have an aim. I try to beat my body down. So that when I run, I'll be a castaway. Lord, let vision come to us, oh God. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Let's continue. We're going to go forward as well. We're going to make prayer part of our lives. Part of our work life. Part of our business life. Prayer. Pray with all manner of supplication. That's what the Bible encourages us to do. We need to pray about our lives, about the things we are putting our hands into, about the jobs that God is giving us. We'll pray on them. You know, I remember I shared this with Scott. I said, when I was coming to this country, there was a piece of land I had. And God knew that that was how I could raise money to pay for some of my ticket and part of the, you know, my living expense here. At that time in Nigeria, I found out that a group of people had entered the land and they started cultivating the land, and the land was in dispute. I didn't know. And one day, the man that took the land was there, and a snake in that land beat him and killed the man in the land. So the rest of his family has stuff from that land. And he was asked by God, said, did you know and kill for a man? I said, how? He said, that man that died there, he died while in that land fighting to take over your land. And a snake came from that land and beat him and killed him there, such that the other people in his community all backed out and said, take your land. That's how I was able to get it back. So God can go far. So you have to use the power of prayer. It works. It really works. And that will be our prayer, and that will be our portion in Jesus' name. The other thing, because one of the things I've learned is, yes, we can preach, but God also expects us to teach people how they can, you know, practically things we need to do. The other thing is to make a balance between short-term goals and long-term goals. In the next 2 years, where do you want to see yourself? Do you think about it? In the next 4 months, by the end of the year, where do you want to see yourself? There should be a balance between short-term and long-term. We should set aside time in our life where we just go into a place and just think. It doesn't happen. How many people do that often? Few. God wants us to spend time to balance both the short day, like going to work on a day-to-day basis, and the long term. Because if you balance the long term with the short term, you will have a picture of where you have a direction. So you know, you're not just beating the bush, but you're going somewhere. And that will be a portion in the name of Jesus. Long-term plan, balance the short-term. It might not be easy now, yes, that is a fact. But I'm putting in things in motion that will help me reach my goal.
Thank you.